So the first question of this episode is like we would like to know what is Indian classical music like.
As we, I think all of us must have heard about classical music, that we talk a lot about rags, we talk a lot about taal, and we talk a lot about improvisation. Indian classical music is 80% improvisation, and 20% is already fixed or predetermined compositions which we learn. And we learn them through our gurus, and it's more of a maukik vidya, meaning that our guru either plays or sings it in front of us, and without notating it, we learn it by ear. And in that process, we learn a lot of things. So Indian classical music is music which has been taught to us traditionally. Like, we live with our guru, we go to them regularly, and on a very regular basis, we have classes for like an hour, 2 hour, 3 hour with them. And through a period of 5 to 6 years, we start developing the sense about classical music. So that much it takes.
Okay, and can you tell us, everybody, including me, you know, about your journey? Because, you know, as guitar players, we have weekly one class, and I used to stay somewhere else. Hardly in a month, I used to go to a teacher. So this is not as serious as what you people do. So if you can tell a little bit about your journey being an Indian classical musician, you know, how you do lessons and all.
I started my musical journey in 2011. I was doing this job and I left everything and I went to a guru and I started learning classical music. It's been more than 8 years that I've been learning from him now. And I lived in a Gurukul for 5.5 years. I went through a rigorous training program. We used to have class at random times of the day, sometimes 4 o'clock in the morning, sometimes after dinner, 9 to 12 the classes will go on. And like that, we used to have classes. Other than the classes, we used to practice a lot. There was a lot of practice routine which was involved and which was being introduced to us, that, you know, if I get just one scale in a class, suppose I'm a beginner and I'm learning to play flute, so we won't use this big of a flute. Okay. We'll use a smaller one, but on that smaller one also, we'll try to learn a scale first. For example, if I'm learning Bilawal Thatt I'm practicing billable tat. So my guru will tell Shitej, you have to practice this 108 times at least. Like, okay, then what will I do is, I'll learn, in the class we'll learn about it, like what is billable tat. Billable tat is all shuddha notes or all no sharps, no minors, all shuddha swaras. So billable tat is essentially I think maybe that will be a scale. So we used to practice this scale throughout, and we used to practice this scale day in and day out. Nothing was given to us, just this, to practice this. Then we started developing speed and accuracy in this scale. So initially I used to play it at, slowly the increased our speed, then it became, so like that we'll keep on practicing. And in my training routine, this was also a major part of my training. So other than getting knowledge from my guru and understanding how it is working, the how rags and improvisation are working, this was also practicing technical things was also a huge part of my training. So I think that's,
yeah, it requires a lot of discipline, man. You know, in guitar class every day the student wants a new song. So Shitej, can you talk a little bit about, you know, what is the difference between ragas and scales, and also for our viewers, you know, if somebody is practicing the flute or maybe guitar, like most of my viewers in this YouTube channel,
mm-hmm.
how we can just get started with basic practice. So this is what we would like to know. Actually, this is two questions. So,
okay,
like the difference between rag and scale, or the introduction,
mm-hmm.
how do we understand or what is it, and then ways to practice and a basic raga, maybe, you know, which you can recommend us so that we can just get started.
I think we can start talking about the concept of rag before actually going into what is rag and what is scale and what rag we might practice right now as a beginner. So like I demonstrated in the previous question, that how do we practice a scale? A rag is a combination of notes, and these notes might resemble to a particular assigned scale. For example, if I take a rag called rag Bhupali, then it has notes of sa, re, ga, pa, dha and sa.
So basically,
yes.
So this is a pentatonic scale.
It's a pentatonic.
So then, major pentatonic,
yeah,
scale.
So then this becomes major pentatonic scale. It is still not rag. A rag has a particular movement which we call chalan of a rag. Like how does a rag moves? Just by playing sa re ga pa da sa doesn't make it a rag Bhupali or any other rag. But if we understand the rules of it, meaning that, as I said, rag has a chalan, we call it a chalan, that is a movement, the way we move into that scale, that establishes the rag, not only the notes of the scale.
Okay.
So
notes, give an example.
I will give, yes. So just to keep it in a very simple way, notes of a rag are like a foundation.
Okay.
The scale of a raga is a foundation on which the rag is built. Obviously, without scale, rag won't be able to come out, because we need notes to express, right? We need swara to express. But a rag is much more than that. A rag is a whole structure, right? We were talking about this rag called rag Bhupali. You said it is major pentatonic because
yes,
it has five notes, sa, re, ga, pa, dha. Okay. So if we take rag Bhupali, just by playing, we are only playing the scale of rag Bhupali. This is not rag Bhupali. What rag Bhupali will be? So going into a technicality of it, I revolved a lot around the note Ga or Gandhar. Sa re dha sa re ga.
The major third.
Yes. Okay. So if I follow this movement, then it becomes Rag Bhupali. If I change my concentration from Ga to a different note, it becomes a different rag.
Although
the notes remain. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Example. In Rag Deskar, we emphasize a lot on Dha or on the upper tetrachord of the scale, meaning we emphasize more on the Uttarang part of it rather than the Purvang part of it. We call it Purvang. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Purvang.
Okay.
And Pa. Ma pa dha ni sa is Uttarang.
Okay.
So something which is looking upwards in octave is Uttarang, and something which is looking towards you in octave is Purvang. So sa re ga pa, this is Purvang, and ga pa dha sa Purvang.
Okay.
Understood. So if we divide the scale from pa to pa, like sa re ga ma pa and ma pa dha ni sa. And that is how we determine what rag is there. First of all, on which note we are concentrating.
Okay, so actually you are dividing it in two parts. And
yeah.
You are calling one part as
Purvang, towards me, Uttarang, away from me.
Okay.
Like
so
that.
It's basically you are cutting something.
Yeah.
And you are thinking of this part as towards you and this part away from me.
Yes. pardon me. So in Rag Bhupali, as we are discussing, we concentrate a lot on Gandhar, Ga, the third note of it.
Okay.
So that note on which we concentrate a lot is called Vadi of that rag. Vadi meaning important swara.
Okay.
And the note on which we concentrate lesser than that, but we still do, we emphasize a lot on that is Dha in Rag Bhupali. So that note is called Samvadi. So a rag is made by Vadi and Samvadi, meaning a note and a note which is talking to it, Samvad kar raha hai, meaning it is talking.
Okay.
Huh? So Dha sa re ga, ga re pa ga pa re, sa re dha sa re ga. So how it is talking, like, you know, these two notes, I can see, like the way I depict them is, they are literally talking to each other. So I am again coming back to this note. It's not like that I overall create, throughout my concert, I will be playing these same things. I will definitely improvise. I'll definitely go up in the octave also, but my concentration point will be Gandhar.
Okay,
so that,
like, you're resolving back to,
yes, I'm resolving back to Ga. That becomes, and so I'm resolving back to the Vadi swar of the raga.
So when we play major scale, we tend to resolve back to the.
We are resolving
the
again
note.
On the root note.
Yes.
So other than root note, yes, root note, we are resolving at root note. But other than root note also, we go towards the Vadi and Samvadi, and that is how a rag is made. First, the scale of rag comes.
Okay.
Scale meaning how many notes it has. Okay, what notes are those? Does it have 7 notes or 6 notes or 5 notes? And what notes are those? Are all of them Shuddh Swaras, meaning all of them major notes? Or are all of, or is any one of them minor note, or like that? So there are so many permutations.
Achha, what is a thaat?
Thaat is a set of notes which goes up and down in the same manner. There are no jumping around it.
Okay, so it means.
Correct. Yes. In these notes, the note can be sharp or flat.
Okay.
And there can be a combination of one flat note, one sharp note, like that. Okay. So in Carnatic music system, we have 72 of them.
In Carnatic?
Yes. In Carnatic music system, we have 72 of them. In Hindustani system, we follow a third paddhati in which we have 10 of them. 10 thards overall. One of them is, we were talking about thard bilawal. Okay. So you can say thard is like a tree and rags are like the fruit of it. Okay, so a thaat will have every note which a rag has. Thaat, we say that.
So basically, thaat is a directory, and from there you take
yes
the things and that you need and you make.
Yes, and thaats and thaats were made to classify rags. At a point of time, we had a lot of rags. How to classify them? How to practice one thing so that we can be benefited in all of them. So that is when they came up with the concept of thaat. Okay, this is a thaat, and from this thaat, this much rags are belonging. So like that,
it's like classic, a family.
Yes, like a family. So if you take thaat bilawal, so from thaat bilawal there is a rag called rag hansadhwani.
Okay.
Notes are. Okay, I have no clue.
Sa. Then.
Ka. Pa. Yes. Yes.
So it's a major nine arpeggio.
Okay. So this belongs to thaat bilawal. Then there is another rag called rag bihag. It is pretty famous. These both rags are very famous in Indian classical music. So rag bihag is also from bilawal thaat. Okay. Now you listen to rag bihag. Hansadhwani.